In this video, I'm going to show you the best export settings that you can use to export your video outside of Premiere Pro for YouTube. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So I'm inside Premiere Pro, and to get started, I have my finished sequence here and I want to export it out. The first thing that you want to do is make sure that whatever you have in your timeline, you want to export. For example, here in my timeline, I have this leftover footage. Now, if you have leftover footage that you don't want to export, you can simply delete it and export it as is. But say if you want to leave this in, what you'll have to do is make in and out markers in your timeline. So I'm going to change my current time indicator to be at the beginning of my timeline. I'm going to click I on my keyboard to make an endpoint, and then I'm going to navigate to the end of my timeline. I'm going to go to the very last frame, and I'm going to click the back arrow once to go to the very last frame that's visible here. And then inside my timeline, with it selected, I'm going to go and click O on my keyboard to set an out point. We're going to use these in and out points to export with. So if we zoom out here, once you have your in and out points, we can go over to the export tab. This is at the top left corner here. We can click export, and this window will appear. First things first, next to range, just be sure that you switch it from entire source to source in and out. That uses the in and out points that we just created here. And then at the top left, we have our beginning options here. We can change our file name. By default, it uses the name of your sequence. So typically when I create my sequences, I usually name it the way I want it to export, but you can always change it there. Under that, you have location. So here you can change where to save the file. I'm going to save it in my downloads folder for now. And then under preset, I already created my YouTube preset, but for now, I recommend starting with Match Source Adaptive High Bitrate. This will just match your video clip and your timeline, so at the very least, it will be somewhat accurate to the best settings, but we're gonna tweak it even more. Now under format, there's H.264, so be sure that's selected. There is H.265, and there are some resources on the internet explaining what H.265 is, when and how to use it. But when it comes to YouTube's recommended upload settings, they do still recommend H.264. And if you're curious, I will leave a link down in the video description to this article explaining YouTube recommended upload encoding settings. You can see right here, container MP4 and video codec H.264. So we're going to be using this for this video. If we go back into Premiere Pro, we can go down under basic video settings. So underneath the video tab, we can click this match source button. And this will match the source to the sequence setting. So this matches your sequence. Your frame size should all match. So in this case, I have a 1080p sequence at 29 frames a second, progressive field order, square pixels, that should all be correct. And if we scroll down here, you have more options right here. I recommend checking these two boxes here just to be safe. It doesn't hurt, you know, it just makes sure that it renders out your video at the best quality. And if we scroll down, a few other options here under encoding settings. I would choose hardware encoding if it's possible. You can always choose software encoding if that's not available. It really depends on your GPU. And one other setting in here I change is the profile. I switch it typically from main to high. And then if we scroll down, we can go down under bitrate settings. Now for YouTube, they have a whole catalog here that explains what your bitrate should be depending on your frame rate and resolution. So if you go under the bitrate section, if we go under SDR uploads, we can see that for 1080p video, it recommends 8 Mbps for 30 frames per second frame rate. Or if you shoot at a high frame rate, it recommends 12. And then obviously if you shoot in 4K, 8K, you're gonna need more. So just follow these settings if you are in a different resolution here. Like I said, I'll leave this article in the link below. So if we go back here, I'm going to change our bitrate settings to 8, as that's what's recommended for the resolution and the frame rate. And then for bitrate encoding settings, I recommend VBR 1-pass. If you want to learn more about bitrate specifically, I did make a video going over it, what CBR and VBR is, but for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to select this for now. Next, under audio, AAC is the recommended codec. And then if we go back into our link here, you can see stereo 384 kilobits per second. So we'll just change it to that. Underneath the bitrate for audio. And that's pretty much it for video and audio. Once you have everything complete, you'll notice at the bottom right, Just to recap, I usually double check this section, just make sure everything looks correct. It gives the estimated file size. It gives the video codec, all the settings that we just covered. And once you're ready, you can click export. And this will export out your video. So there you have it. Those are the best YouTube export settings for 2024. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comment section below. And as always, consult that article if you're watching this in the future. You never know, the settings might change. But that does it for this video. I hope you found it helpful, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.